We've been the victim of the use of chemical weapons before by Saddam Hussein. So definitely we sympathize very much with the Syrian victims who suffered from this, and we want a ban on chemical weapons and to bring the perpetrators to justice.
Banning chemical weapons will not stop the bloodshed in Syria.
Definitely it won't. But there is an effort to push for a political solution through the Geneva II conference. We were present at the first Geneva, and this will be a continuation of the same process, hoping to find a durable political resolution that will meet the Syrian people's aspirations.
Let me ask you this, as you talk about a durable political solution, can that include President Bashar al-Assad remaining as president?
Well, Bashar, he will not directly participate in these talks, you see, in Geneva. I mean, that's,
but would negotiations be with the aim of removing him?
Of course, but there would be a transitional period. This would be up to the Syrian opposition and the representative of the regime to decide and agree on a political process, let's say, to move to a new election and for the Syrian people to decide for themselves whether they like Bashar or not, to change him.
Now talk to me about the impact the Syrian war is having
it
on
has.
Your country.
Is
your country slipping into a civil war?
And not to civil war, but really the spillover from Syria has been affecting Iraq in many ways. And because of the geographical proximity, because of the strong social, national connections, and because of the movement of the terrorist networks and groups across the border.
The belief among many is that Iran, being a close ally of Syria, is fueling the conflict. Iran is an ally of Iraq. Are you putting pressure on the Iranian regimes? Are you speaking
to them and telling them
to stop doing that?
We definitely have our own independent policy here. We are not following Iranian orders or anybody else. We have our own national interest at stake because we are affected immediately. Iran has its own policy. It supports Bashar Assad, supports the Syrian regime. But this is not the position of Iraq. I think the Iraqi position is it's up to the Syrian people to decide who is their leader.
And finally, Mr. Minister, considering the situation on the ground in Iraq, part of it due to the spillover from Syria, some say part of it due to the lack of inclusiveness in your own country
what are you doing to
bring about long-term peace and stability?
No, definitely. We have our own failures.
Yes.
I mean, the stronger the unity, the political unity, the inclusiveness, the less security problems we face. And this is a process we are addressing. Recently, we had a conference in Baghdad attended by all the political leaders, and they adhered to an accord of honor. They signed a document for social peace, not to resort to violence, but this needs to be seen to be implemented on the ground.
Absolutely. But you have hope you can keep Iraq on an even keel?
I believe so. No, I'm a great believer in the future of this country to rise again, to stand on its feet with the support of all the good and willing people.